Hey guys, it's Caden here, and it's about it's 4:30 here in the UK, so, well, it's 4:30. Right, so 4:30 meaning we're getting ready for the gym, as usual. So I've just run through kind of like a go-through procedure. So I usually have like a big meal after work, so I'm up at 5:30 every morning, well not every morning, like 3 days a week, and I'll get back from work about 2:30, so I leave at 6:15 in the morning, do 6:30 till 2:00. And I'll get home and eat a big meal. Today I had like this steak thing, pretty nice, like 26 grams of protein. Some chips and mixed vegetables, you know. You can mix it up. I usually go with chicken and rice or wrap some chicken with mixed vegetables. But yeah, so today's workout, we've got bench, shoulders and triceps. So I'm gonna get a bit of recording in the gym. Yeah, we'll just get a little bit of content. I'll either speak through it or I'll have a little voiceover. Preparing for the gym, I usually go with, if I can move my camera somewhere a little bit better, so I can kind of show you what I'm doing. So yeah, here we go. So, I've got brand of cycling here, cyclic dextrin. So this is kind of like, you know, like kind of like a Lucozade or a G Fuel if you're in America kind of thing. Basically I've got my powder. This one is strawberry and lime, so it tastes alright. I kind of put a bit too much powder in for it to actually taste nice, but so I usually just kind of fill this water bottle to about like there, well, there-ish. Yeah, this is the tricky part. If I had like a funnel, it'd be ideal, but we don't, so we do it the old-fashioned way of just kind of scooping it in. So there's one scoop, and then one more. Well, there you go, that's where you get a funnel. But in this is like one scoop is 25 grams of carbs. I mean, it's not the best of carbs, but it's decent. Like I'm saying, like it's not full of sugar, I think anyway. But I take two scoops of this, and I'll wrap this and take this to the gym with me. I just sip this through my workout, it was intra workout. Tastes all right. Just kind of give it a bit of a shake. And then before I drink it at the gym, I do like another kind of shake, just like in case it gets clumpy or whatever, because it, you know, yeah, I mean, I would be able to show it. Yeah, it just gets clumpy, it's not good. But then the next bit of my pre-workout, after I've had like a big meal after work, if I can open this, that'd be nice. Also for brand, I go with Bodybuilding Warehouse. I'm not sponsored by them, but hey, if you want to sponsor me, I'm here. But the next part is, of course, a bit of caffeine. I just go with two scoops of coffee. I kind of stick away from pre-workouts unless I'm going for like some kind of PR or something, because you know, whatever's in that shit is, it's definitely not good for you. Definitely not. I mean, I used to take it like quite a lot. It is good fun, don't get me wrong, but I used to find like an issue eating after the gym. So like, I'd get home and I just wasn't hungry and kind of like spaced out, you know, from whatever in that pre-workout. But yeah, just, about the ingredient, creatine. So I usually take 5 grams a day. So I usually just whack this in my morning coffee. But recently I've kind of been trialing out 10 grams of creatine a day. My digestive system's completely fine with it, so I'm just gonna kind of rock with it. Because I'm trying to gain up to 74 kilo by November 6th, because that's when I'm competing. Hopefully hitting some right numbers, but at the moment we're sitting at body weight about 70 kilo, like comfortably. I mean, we're aiming for another 4 kilo on top, and I'm eating so much food. I think before this 50 grams of carbs we've got in that, and this coffee, which is still another, like a decent amount of calories, I think I've eaten 2,000 calories today, and I woke up at 5:30, so, you know, you can see how much I'm eating, and that was with no cooked breakfast and work, that was actually just a sandwich. But yeah, what I'll do is, this will be the pre-workout. I add milk to this, by the way, I think it will actually help. Here we go, here's this bad boy. Also some other recommendations, like what I'll do after the gym is usually have like a Cocoa Pops bar. I was watching this bodybuilding thing, like this bodybuilding like shopping thing, and he went to the gym afterwards, And he swears by having like a squares bar or like a cereal bar to get the protein acting work, like acting faster. I'm not sure how it works, but apparently that works like that. So I always kind of add like a Cocoa Pop bar or a squares bar after my workout. Puts us extra carbs in the day, so it gives me more energy and a little bit of extra body fat, hopefully. So I'll get this down, do the normal thing, maybe if I go for, you know, the number two if I need to go before I go to the gym, because about a 20 minute walk. So I'll drink this and then head to the gym, and hopefully it's digested by that point. That's when we'll start our stretching for bench, which I'll go through. So I'll meet you guys in the gym. Starting off with Cobra stretch and a child's pose. Two sets of 30 seconds each, just to get the lower back and the upper back stretched for bench so we can get a good arch. So that's the plan. So after bench, we're looking at Sponto press for 3 sets of 4, RP7, which is pausing above the chest for an inch for about 2 seconds, just to get used to kind of the weight there. But yeah, that's the plan. Okay, so after Sponto press, we've got, what's it called now? Lateral raises, 3 sets of 20, and then we're going to face pulls, so.
Smoking that gas, got all that sign, and she on the powder. Nowadays, I am on my head, I got sadder. Money got longer, speaker got louder, car got faster. Turned to a savage, pocket got fatter, she got me daddy. Smoking that gas, got all that sign, and she on the powder. Nowadays, I am on my head, I got sadder. Money got longer, speaker got louder, car got faster. Money so old, dollar spoiled. Never thought that it'd be days I could.
to a savage, but I got fat, she got me daddy. So we just finished the session. Quite a large pump. We were sitting at like 70 kilo. But yeah, it was a nice push session. Bench feels actually nice now, so. Also, I do recommend sponsor press if you guys never tried it. It's good for like when you get to the bottom of the rack where you're feeling like less tight. Just help you with the tightness when you come back to the bench press and pause. But I'm gonna say goodbye to a few people in the gym now, so we'll fucking have that voice crack. So you guys can join me. Wild Benjamin. Right. Hello, Ben. I didn't have to turn the camera on. Hello. I'm saying goodbye now.
Did you see me? I'm like, swing him out,
I scared you, man. Right.
Sound
brother. Wild Joe. See you later, Joe.
Going up.
Yeah,
see
you later, bro. Go on, easy.
Push.
Goodbye, mate.
Bye.
It's so weird.
It's not easy. Hey, bro.
The gym is not easy.
It's not.
The grind never stops.
Here.
Right. Hour on the quest for Cocoa Pop bars. Let's find them. Gosh. Actually, two of them. Okay, so I'm finishing the video here. Just walking back from the gym now. Had two Cocoa Butt bars as well. If you guys can like, comment, and subscribe down below and ask, like, well, leave down in the comments below what you want to see next. I can carry on with the vlogs or I can carry on with, like, exercise tips. You guys let me know. So remember, consistency is key, guys.